Hello, what's up guys, Alex Gomez here. On today's video I'm gonna show you how to create a logo in Maya using Adobe Illustrator. So when you export your logo in Curves as Adobe Illustrator, make sure that it's a version 8 to be able to work with Maya. So export it as a Adobe Illustrator version 8. So let's open up Maya, let's go to import and let's look for the file. Have it logo 8. Logo, there you go. We're gonna import it. I'm gonna group it and then I'm gonna press F to see where it is, and I'm gonna center the pivot. So center the pivot to make sure that you guys have the pivot is right in the middle. I'm gonna just put it right in the middle of my grid, rotate it in x-axis, and then I'm gonna apply go to surface. Sorry, I'm just gonna select the outside curve, then the inside, go to surface, go to bevel plus, and if you want to pause the video here and check my settings, just pause the video and check the settings that I have, and then go to output options and set up to 20 there. Okay, go apply and we have our piece of geometry there, and then we do the same with the other piece. Okay, so now that we have our logo right there, we're gonna select both pieces and we're gonna delete history. Okay, so we can delete our curves. Let's do that. History, I can go to edit and delete all by type history, or also I can just press Control Shift and then go to edit and click delete history just to put it where my custom shelf is, just to put that button there. Okay, so make sure we just move it up and then we're gonna create a plane. So let's create a plane here. We don't need that anymore. I split my viewport in two so I can have one for the camera. Yeah, let's create a camera first. Let's create a camera and go to the camera here. Set up the camera, nice angle. I tried to change it to the focal length to 90, but I think I change it back again. Didn't like as much. 35 is fine. It's for this exercise. Okay, so let's set up a really good angle for you guys. Okay, and in the render settings, we're gonna go to 540 by 540 for now. The width and the height for the size of our render. Okay. So okay, now that we have our, go to view, then go camera settings and resolution gate. So we know what is the camera gonna capture. Okay, now that we have a nice angle, we're just gonna lock the camera just in case. Okay, perfect. Now after that, now we're gonna create the plane. So let's go to poly modeling, create the plane. I just scale it up a lot until it is covered in our camera. Okay, I use Redshift for rendering. So let's open up our Hypershade and create two materials, one for the plane and one for the logo. So I'm using Redshift, so I'm just gonna use a standard material, a Redshift material, and perfect. Let's see if it's on my computer today. That's fine. And we're gonna assign it to our logo, the first material. Then create the second material, and we're gonna assign it to the plane or background. And the first material we're gonna call it logo underscore RS, and then the second we're gonna call it plane underscore RS. Okay, so let's start playing with the colors first. No, we're gonna just create some lights first. So let's go create a physical light or an area light if you're using other render engines. I make the shape as a disc. I don't make it visible, so my camera doesn't see it. Let's move it up. So after this process, I'm going to start IPR rendering, so I can start setting up the lights, intensity, and stuff. And let's get intensity a little bit lower, like how it is a little bit too much for this exercise. Okay, so let's go to IPR. If you're using Arnold, it's the same process. There it goes. Okay, so that's gonna render my perspective here. So let's go switch to our camera. And we have it here, we have our logo. Great, now we're gonna go to our hypershade again. Or we can just go in the attribute editor and go to the material and just change the color to it. So like a little pink like that. And I find that it's too shiny, so I'm just gonna increase the roughness. Put around like 0.4, 0.5, maybe enough. Okay, I like the look of it. And now we're gonna do the same with the plain material. So select the plane and go to the attribute editor. Okay. And just make it a little darker. In this case, we're not gonna use the roughness because I want the plane to be very reflective. So duplicate the light that we just created and then just move it to the other side, just to give a little bit of light in our right of the screen. Move it, so get it outside, kind of like, so you don't see that it's reflecting from our plane. Yep. Perfect. And we can add some color. I like to play with blues and yellow, so one side in this right side, I'm just gonna add a little bit of tint of blue, and in the other side, just gonna add a little bit of tint of yellow. Okay, perfect. So now we are going to get the other light, we're gonna duplicate it, and we're gonna move it to the back of our logo. And then we're gonna move it back so it's not like reflecting in our calendar. And increase the size, I think we can scale up. First, so we get a little bit of that highlight right there. We're seeing this showing up a highlight in the top of the O, kind of thing, the circle. It kind of like gives a little bit a pop, that highlight there. And as I say, I just scale it up. Okay, so that's looking pretty cool. So if you guys are happy with that image, set up, I think Redshift and Arnold works the same. If you have to work your samples from the bottom up, so for example, my samples in Redshift, I start with the samples on the lights, so I increase the samples on the lights, and then I increase the samples on the render settings. So let's go samples 256. I know that Arnold works in different samples, like 3, 4, and 5, so make sure you just or 6, make sure you just increase the ones from the materials, lights, and then the general samples in Redshift. I just go with the lights first. Redshift is pretty good, like it's amazing. I totally recommend this render engine. Like honestly, it just flies. It's really, really fast. Like I can render this 1080 by 1080 like for an Instagram post, and this takes literally like 10 to 20 seconds to render. So it's also depends on your graphic card. I have an NVIDIA 2080 Ti and it just flies. Okay, so let's do, like, I change here just to put it on an Instagram story or something. So see how fast it goes. It really, really goes really fast. So you're gonna see the time. So that took 15 seconds. So it's pretty fast for a good quality of the image. So now I'm gonna go with the unified samples, and I'm gonna go minimal samples 16, maximum samples 226. In the GI, I'm gonna go with a brute force and a irradiance point cloud, and I'm gonna render this. First, I'm gonna save this image so you can compare the two for quality. So let's go and render. So you see, we have like a good quality of image, good samples, not much noise, and look how fast it goes. Pretty faster, eh? Perfect. So now that we have that image, we can just save it, and that's kind of like you can see like the difference between one with GI and the other one without the GI. So the second one that has the GI kind of like it brights up a little bit more. Okay, so save your logo, render it, make it cooler, and yeah, thank you so much. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm gonna be creating more tutorials. I've been a little bit busy lately, but yeah, more tutorial coming. Please subscribe, share to your friends, and yeah, like visit me on GomezStar3D if you want to see awesome characters, and you know, keep being awesome, guys. Take care. Bye.